Actually, it's been better this year than previous years. People have been more open to poetry, and we have a wonderful audience in here today who are actually now, I can officially say, better than the audience we had yesterday. give yourselves a clap. You saw me do a little bit with Ashley earlier, and I'm going to do a little bit more now. This is, I think this is what you get when you cross poetry and drama. Carol Ann Duffy does an incredible range of poems which are the wives of famous characters, mythical or real. This particular poem is called Mrs. Aesop. Christ, he could bawl for purgatory. He was small, didn't prepossess, so tried to impress. And dead men, Mrs. Aesop, tell no tales. Well, let me tell you, the bird in his hand, shut on his sleeve, never mind the two, worth less in the bush. Tedious. Going out was worse. He'd stand at the gate, look, then leap, scour the hedgerows for a shy mouse, the fields for a sly fox, the skies for that one particular swallow that doesn't make a summer. The jackdaw, according to him, envied the eagle, and donkeys would, on the whole, prefer to be lions. On one appalling evening stroll, we passed a hare snoozing in a ditch. He stopped, made a note. About a mile further on, a tortoise, somebody's pet, creeping as slow as marriage up the road. Slow but steady, Mrs. Aesop wins the race. Arsehole. What race? What sour grapes, silk purse, what sow's ear, dog in a manger, what big fish? Oh, some days I could barely stay awake as the story droned on to the eventual moral of itself. Actions, Mrs. I, speak louder than words, and that's another thing. The sex was diabolical. I told him a story one night about a little cock that couldn't crow, about an axe with a heart blacker than the pot that killed the pot that called the kettle. I'll cut off your tail, all right, despite my face. That shut him up. I laughed last. Longest. Thank you.